Hello, I'm Paddy from creativemedia.org.uk and I'm going to do a review of an app for the iPad. I'll let you know if it's available on Android as well, but it's particularly useful for the iPad. I bought this iPad a while ago and I was very excited about the processing power it had, which is probably faster than this MacBook Pro that I bought quite a long time ago. It's a 2011 one. So I thought I could do all my video processing on the iPad and it would be amazingly quick. But I soon found out that getting files from the camera or from the computer onto the iPad is quite tricky. It seemed the most straightforward way was to upload everything to a cloud service like iCloud or Google Drives and then download it again. And my upload speed can sometimes be as slow as 0.4 or lower megabits per second. So by the time it's uploaded and downloaded again, I've lost the creative spark and I might as well have just done it on a slower computer sort of straight away and waited for it to process. Another option would be to use iTunes, but I couldn't get the right version of iTunes to match the version of iTunes on this, and all that kind of syncing just seemed overly complicated when you should just be able to copy the files from here to here. It's not really very far. It shouldn't have to go up to a cloud service just to get this very short distance. Well, I found an app which might well solve your problems. It certainly solved a lot of mine and solved a few other things which I hadn't thought of as well. So let's go into screen grab mode and I'll show you FileMaster. I'm going to show you some of the features of FileMaster and I'm going to show you the best one right at the end because it's so good. I love it. There are several different applications called FileMaster in the App Store. It's the one with the white F on a blue background by Shenzhen Yumi Information Technology. It's free to install, but you get adverts. If you want the free version, it's £2.99, which for the value of what it'll do is an amazing price. It's an alternative file system to Apple's file system. If you take a picture using the built-in camera, you won't find any of these pictures in FileMaster, but there is a way of getting them in. If you go to More, you can choose Import Photos, and you can import any of the photos from the iPad's camera into the FileMaster file system. The same applies to any video shot with the iPad, including screen capture. So I'm going to be using FileMaster to copy this screen grab that you're watching now onto my laptop so I can edit it. It also has its own built-in browser, very basic browser. It's got the bookmarks, so I can choose my website here. And a great thing about it is there's a rather anachronistic disk drive icon at the top right, and you can save the page to a PDF, which is just amazing. You can just save it to your device. So here's my PDF, and it's got a basic PDF viewer in as well. You can hold your finger down on any file, you can delete it, you can zip it, you can do a zip with password, you can share, you can send to not very many places, email. So you can send it as an email as well from inside FileMaster. Well, there's properties as well, which is vaguely useful. And a hide function. So delete that, you can rename as well, which is useful. So that's the browser. There's a basic camera as well. That's the floor of my loft we're looking at. You can do video or photos with it. It hasn't got any clever features, apart from a zoom in and a zoom out. And when you take pictures with that, it saves it into FileMaster's file area rather than the iPad's file area. The next useful feature, which I use a lot, is Now Playing. It's a very basic MP3 player. You can create playlists. So I've got a playlist of all my favourite music here. And I've also got playlists of backing tracks because I use my iPad to play back backing tracks when I'm doing gigs. So my backing tracks have a single file in to make sure that when I finish performing, it doesn't start playing the next backing track or some other track. You've got the option to loop, all loop once, random play, or no loop. I use no loop when I'm doing a gig because I don't want the file to start again. I'll show you the settings very quickly as well. There's an app password. I guess that allows you to lock whether people can get into it or not. Authentication, don't know about that. Oh, show hidden files. So the file I hid earlier on, I could make sure I couldn't see that if I put hidden files switched on there. There's a history for the browser, which you can turn on, turn off. There's a trash you can enable. I've got that turned off. There seems to be a cloud disk. I'm not sure. Oh, that probably shows any cloud services you've got installed. So you can send stuff to the cloud via this if you've got it turned on, but I don't want it on personally. And it tells you how much space you've got left as well. Right, on to the amazing feature, Wi-Fi transfer. As long as you're on the same wireless as any other device, so any device that you type this number in on will connect directly to the files within FileMaster. For example, when I finish doing this screen capture, I'll import that into FileMaster, which will be quick because it's just happening inside the iPad itself. Then I will use my wireless network to transfer that directly to my laptop so I can edit on it. And it doesn't matter whether that's a PC or a Mac, a new one or an old one, or even any kind of Android or Apple phone. Anything with a browser, you should be able to copy the files from the iPad directly across to the other device by using this address. And you can also, once you've connected to this address here, you can delete files on the iPad from the other device. And you can also upload files from the other device to the iPad, which is what I did with my music collection. I could just choose which files I wanted to copy. And it happens very quickly. It's all just down to the speed of your wireless network. So yeah, get FileMaster if you're frustrated with copying files to and fro on your iPad or iPhone, or if you just have had it up to here with Apple's system of doing things and you want to break free a little bit. Thanks for watching, and like, subscribe, etc. Share if you like the videos. There's lots on my channel, all kinds of different subjects, so feel free to browse.